Hello, my name is Tyrone Dillard, and I am the 4-H agent in Camden County with North Carolina Cooperative Extension. Today, I'd like to talk to you about the states of matter, solids, liquids, and gases. What is matter? Matter is anything that takes up space. There are examples of matter all around us. If you take a look at the picture, you will find milk, Coke, a bell, balloons, pear, books, a hot air balloon, and an ink pen. One example of a liquid would be milk. One example of a solid would be the book. One example of a gas would be the air inside the two balloons. What is a solid? A solid is a form of matter that has a definite shape. It cannot be easily smashed, squashed, stretched, or changed. If you look below, there are some examples of solids: wood, butter, and a big rock. What is a liquid? A liquid is a form of matter that has a specific amount of volume, which means a specific amount of space that it takes up. It does not take on or have a definite shape, and it takes on the shape of whatever it is placed in. For example, if you look at the picture below, you will see water being poured into a glass. The water takes on the shape of the glass. Also, other liquids include milk and honey. What is a gas? A gas is a form of matter that expands to fill the space it is given, and it does not have a specific shape. Some examples include air, natural gas, and helium that is commonly found in balloons. There are also physical changes of matter. They are solid to liquid, liquid to solid, liquid to gas to liquid, solid to gas, and gas to solid. Let's make butter. This is a super fun activity, and what we are going to try to do is see if we can cause a liquid to change into a solid. You will need one mason jar. An 8-ounce jar works great for kids, but a large one is fine. One container of heavy whipping cream, a pinch of salt if desired, two hands, and strong arms for lots of shaking. Let's put it all together. Fill the mason jar about half full with heavy whipping cream. Add a pinch of salt if desired. Place the lid on the jar and close it tightly. Shake for 7 to 10 minutes. It may take longer or not as long, depending on how fast you shake. Make it fun. Play music and take turns shaking the jar. This is a wonderful family activity. Open the jar about every 2 minutes and observe the changes that are taking place. Let's shake. Thank you. Now that you've finished shaking, we should have butter and buttermilk. If you take a look at the picture, there's butter in the bowl. And also in the jar, the liquid that is left is buttermilk. Let's talk about it. What happened? We start with whipping cream, which is a liquid. When the whipped cream was shaken, it changed from a liquid to a solid. Did you notice that when you first started shaking the liquid, it made a whipped cream before it changed into butter? Why? When shaking the fresh cream, the fat molecules in the cream get shaken out of position and clumped together. Eventually, after enough agitation, the fat molecules are clumped so much that it forms butter. During this process, the fat molecules get separated from the liquid in the cream, and this liquid is called buttermilk and can be removed. The liquid went through a physical change. Now that you have your fresh made butter, you can enjoy it on your favorite bread or a hot biscuit. I would like to thank you for taking the time to watch this presentation and try this fun activity. If you have made butter and would like to show your finished product, you may email me at tldillard@ncsu.edu. Again, my name is Tyrone Dillard. I am the Camden County 4-H agent with North Carolina Cooperative Extension. Thank you.